it's Saturday. Hey, it's Saturday. I got a review for you.
Als Bruce voor deze. Dan hebben we een keep daarin.
Woekak.
No, I haven't been drinking. Well, I have, but it's my first one. I'm just a crazy motherfucker. Anyway, cheers. Cheers, Bruce and Dads. I thought I'd bang out a quick review. Not much to say about it. Local guys really think they made a little banger of a mech squonker. I'm of course talking about the little Monarch Resurgence. Now, haven't been using it for too long, but it really, I mean, it hits, this is 0.3 build on the single coil on the recurve, and yeah, doesn't hit too bad. Yeah, it's lekker. Obviously not a massive, here's the squonking action. Last thing about this, you can squonk, like basically, you can either squonk this side or that side, but I think the idea is because it's open on both sides, you'll see, you can basically just press that and whoop, and it squonks. And it squonks quite lekker. I think they've done a good job. One or two issues, and we'll go through it shortly. On the, I don't even know if I'm going to do a dive down on it. I mean, it's a mech squonker. You've got the plate, you've got the adjustable. That's, so let's quickly go through it. This is a resin mod, so it says resin. So I'm not sure if it's 3D printed. Looking at the material, it doesn't look 3D printed. I couldn't find any. Oh wait, there we go. It is 3D printed. There you can see the marks there. I don't know if you can see it. The marks over there. So it's definitely printed. Like I said, I haven't spent a lot of time with it. I'm running a 0.3 a building at 2.5 mil, so it's not hitting as hard. Obviously, it's all build dependent, depending on your build. I think with this thing, I mean, it hits lekker. It does, you know, it hits, for me, it hits fine. It's not that, but it's instant. Let's quickly go through it. The pros and the cons for me, the use that I've had. First con to me is getting the battery out. Yo, I think because it's such a tight fit, and you can even see, I don't know if you can see, there's, you know, it's raised a bit, so it's definitely is as if it's pressing up this side. So I was a little concerned that it might, you know, get some wear over here with taking in and taking out of batteries, but taking the battery out on a new one is, so basically what you've got to do is you've got to get your finger in there on the, by the squonk bottle side, and then hopefully not try and squonk too much, and you've got to press it out. You see there, it pops out, you see, and I've squonked, which I wouldn't call it a deal breaker. You see now, there we go. There I've gotten out the battery. I must say, taking the battery, you see now there I've got a tear. So there's the first tear over there. I was a bit alarmed about that because the edges over there, let's only use this pointer. The edges over there is quite sharp. So I suppose you can file it down, but then you're gonna file down the and the edge here. Yeah, it's flush. At the top, over there, it's flush. At the bottom, I mean, there's a bit of a, there is a recess, but it is definitely catching. So, I think if they could do the same on the top, on the top, and on the bottom is what they did at the top, where it's like it sits, almost sits flush, and there's no potential issue with, you know, a battery wrap getting bluxomed like this one over here. And I suspect that's when I put it in, actually, not when I took it out. So I'll just make sure that side, let me just see. Yeah, you see it's not fully cut, but there is, there is some slight indentation, but it's not broken. So the battery wrap's not broken. Like I said, I'm not sure if it's now for me putting it in or taking it out, but that's a bit of a con to me, is taking the battery in and out. It's quite a mission. The next con is I haven't found an Atti that says flush. I mean, you can see there, this Atti doesn't sit flush. And your adjustable, I don't know if you'll be able to see it, your adjustment for your 510 happens that just above the squonk pin, you'll see there's like a ring there that you can adjust your 510. Now I've adjusted it all the way to the top, and I mean, and I've screwed this at you all the way down, and yeah, it doesn't sit 100% flush. Might be a deal breaker for some. To me, it's a bit of an annoyance, but I'll see if there's maybe something that I'm doing wrong, but I don't think so. I've checked everything that I could. Squonking action on it, like I said, is definitely not bad. It is something to get used to, the dual. I suppose you can press, no you can't, you see. Oh well, wait, you can. If your battery is up against the bottle, you can from either side, because now at the moment, obviously the bottle's ballooning out as I press it. So obviously with the battery in, you know, when you press, it's going to press against the battery and get quite a good squonking action. The drainage is not bad. Yeah, no, it's draining completely. So it is draining. Like I said, the inside, you see, I'm not even going to try and get the inside of the, and I think that's the reason why this mod hits so hard with the correct build in it, is because the amount of materials for your plate. So you've got about the distance from the center of the battery, well, I'd say from there to there, you've got a plate running from there, and you've got the plate running down, and you've got that distance. Where with in general your mech mods, and I don't have one now that's got the plate in it. It would have been nice to actually compare it to that. But basically, your plate on normal box mech squonkers, if you can call it that, is at least between 2 and 3 mil longer than this one. So, but I mean size-wise, what can I compare it as against the kitty cat puppy? There we go. Like you can see, it's tiny, man. Tiny, tiny, tiny. So that's my daughter's kitty cat puppy. I don't know what else I can compare it. Well, anyway. Yeah, so I think it's definitely a nicely built mod, and honestly, these days, looking at the price of mech squonkers and 3D printed squonkers, it's insane. I mean, a Frankie, I think I saw a Frankie on the forum for $5,000. I mean, this is retail, 1.6, and you've got a mech squonker that hits as hard as any mech squonker out there. A lot of guys, oh no, the bolt hits better. 100%, it's got upgraded silver contacts. If you upgrade this to pure silver or to 99% silver contacts, it's going to hit just as hard. In fact, if not harder, because it's got less travel between your plate and your Atti, so there's less resistance. So that's why, well, to me, you get that perceived harder hitting on this one than, let's say, on a bolt or on a whatever. Now, I've used the previous version, or the previous one, which is the Monarch, the resin one, the milled out one. Like I said, had issues with the 510, but that was because they were still in the beginning phase and it was a first batch. I think this one as well, like I said, I mean, the con there, it does stick out, but for the price, I'm not complaining. And it hits well, eh? It hits well. Just as well as any 5,000 Rand plastic mod that I've come across. I've tried a bolt. I've tried the... What's the other one? It's a weird looking one. The one with the octopus. That one. I've tried a few. And I don't build that low. So to me, it's not about how hard the thing hits. It's just, I build for battery life. I don't build for, this thing hits hard or whatever. To me, it's all relative. It's whatever floats your fancy. And like I said, I'm running a 0.3 in here. And it's like a charm. Okay, so let's go over the pros and the consies. Prosies and the consies. I think I did go over the cons a bit now. So first con to me, when it comes to mods, also a criteria to me is quality of build, materials used, longevity, and I would say probably the 510, is it adjustable, is it not? We're speaking specifically about mech squonkers. Now there's not a lot of criteria you can actually really look at a mech squonker. I mean, a mech squonker is a mech squonker. I'm sure a lot of you guys, I mean, there's a lot of guys that are running Athenas that are, you know, mining the arcing issue. You just use a bit of that dielectric grease and you should be good to go. So the nice thing about this thing is you pop out the battery. It's got a little thing at the bottom that you pop out and that holds the whole thing in place. And I wonder if I can show you. Yeah, let me show you. I mean, it's not that. Okay, again, you got to just grab your finger in there, push out the battery. There we go. Battery's out. So it's actually not that big a con. You see there, see that initial takeout. The top is fine. The bottom is also fine, but I think it's worth the putting in. And then you take out your bottle. That's also a bit of a tricky situation without squonking. You got to, because the bottle is quite a tight fit. I just pull it out like that, whoop, and pull out the bottle, and there's your insides. Now you see at the bottom, there's a little, okay, sorry, that was just a bit of juice dripping out from the atomizer. Let me take off the atomizer quickly. Let's take that out. There we go, there's your naked thing. And it's a question of that little thing at the bottom. It's like a little... what do you call it, sliding mechanism, and now I've got to try and get it out. So you've got to finger fuck it, or I don't know, I've actually never taken this thing apart, because I mean I just got it, so it's like it kind of lifts out, no, it kind of slides out. See, my fingers are too thick. Yeah, see, now I'm not getting it out because it's quite fresh and new. I don't think it's ever been taken out. Well, I haven't taken it out, so I'm not going to try and force it. I wonder if I've got something here. I've got this thing, but I don't want to use this thing because it's not thick enough. No, not going to get it out. But anyway, you get the idea. You slide that little piece out, and this whole L piece, basically, this whole L piece comes out. But I mean, look at the travel. You can see in there, that's the travel that it goes in. I mean, that's about... How many are we? That's about that much travel. And same at the top. You've got that much travel. And then you've got the size of an 18650, if not smaller, travel in length. So all of that combined, if you measure it out and compare it against another, let's say a Bolt's one's going to be way longer. So you've got a lot less resistance. All right, so let's quickly put this thing together. And this to me is another con, is trying to get the bottle back in, because it's kind of, you got to put it at an angle, but you don't have a lot of space to work with. So hopefully I'm going to do it one go. So you got to kind of do that, and then hopefully it's in. Yeah, it looks to be in, and you got to, I don't know, there we go, boop, and it's in. Okay, so it is a bit on the fiddly side. Let me just double check my battery. Battery safety, guys, always first. Battery safety first. Yeah, this battery looks 100%. There's a small. No, it's not. It's not torn, so that's fine. And to put the battery in, you got to put it in pretty much flush. I because of that lippy, I'm worried about that lippy. I put my bottom side in first, and then I'll just slide in. That way you don't catch it on the beginning. Slide it in, boom, there we go. Bang your Eti on. Check it, check everything. Now it's not gonna fire. Oh, there we go. And yeah, I mean, it fires lekker. The button itself is quite, it's a press, see? But it's, once you press it, it's basically, boom, it's there. Yeah, so con-wise, I'm waffling a lot. Con-wise is getting the battery in and out. Getting the bottle in and out takes a bit of practice. I mean, this is, I've done it a few times now. But you get the hang of it. I think taking out, in and out the battery, eventually it's gonna settle in, and it's not gonna be as stiff, because it's like a polycarbonate type of, not polycarbonate, I think it's called a P11 or a P12. I'm not sure which version of plastic they're using, if it's P11 or P12. You know, it is a bit fiddly. Squonking is decent. It's not the best squonking. It uses the Gremlin bottles, the Quill Master bottles. I haven't tried other bottles in it, but any bottle of similar height will work fine. Like I said, button is fairly pronounced, so you gotta press it fairly in the middle there. Okay, there it works, but it is a proper press. What other cons are there? Obviously the Eti not sitting flush. It is a bit of a con for some. To me, it's not that huge a deal. It actually gives me a bit of venting or a bit of airflow underneath the 510, which is fine. Other con, size might be a con to some, that it's too small, because it's really small, guys. I mean, that's it in my hand. I've got little lady hands, so I mean, with guys with really big hands, it might not be counterproductive ergonomics wise that it's too small, actually. But to me, it's perfect, and it's a lekker little mod. You drop it in your pocket. It hasn't got a locking mechanism, which is another con, I have to mention that. But obviously your locking mechanism is up there. It's in your brain, man. Use your head. What else is there? What other cons are there? Obviously being plastic, I'm not gonna do a drop test on it or anything like that. I have spoken to some people, oops, and I over-squonked. I've spoken to one or two guys that have been using it for extensively. I think the one guy actually got one of the first proto models, and he's dropped it down the stairs, he's dropped it on tiles. It's basically like this. Like those old Nokia phones that you get, if you drop it just everything just falls apart. So your battery goes the one way and the thing goes the other way and all this, everything. So, you know, I think it's built fairly strong. And for 1.6, this little portable jobby, I mean, this thing is golden. It's really nice. Pros on it, size for me is definitely a pro. It's portable. You can chuck it in wherever. I don't worry too much about it. There's no too many working parts on it. Ergonomics on it is brilliant. For me, I quite like it with my little lady hands. So it hits well. Like I said, I don't have that much experience with mech squonkers, or what do you want to call it, box squonkers. But I think this thing. Toe to toe with any box mod out there, I think it's all perception. It's all your build that you put in. I mean, if you put a 0.1 build in a bolt and you put a 0.2 in, yeah, of course the bolt's going to hit harder. Depends on your build. I mean, it's all relative. So, and also I must say the support from these guys, Chris and the guys there are brilliant. I mean, I'd rather support local as always. And if you have an issue, you contact them directly either on Instagram, Facebook, I've got your WhatsApp, or whatever. They will send you out a new one. Well, I'm just saying, or they'll fix your issue for you. They'll come through and come sort it out for you. So yeah, big ups to Monarch guys. You've done another stellar job on this. Hope to see you guys soon. I've got my upcoming review. I'm still busy with the not the intake. What am I saying? The Juggernaut Mini. Really impressed with it so far. I think it's a good. It's kind of drawn me back to the top airflow single coil RTAs. I was impressed with the other ones. The intake, not that impressed. I know everybody was like, oh, it's amazing, whatever. I wasn't impressed. Flavor was lacking to me. So, but the Juggernaut, watch out for that review. I might need to eat some humble pie there. Anyway. Go Booker, we're gonna fuck up Wales hopefully, and Vaping Brew, out.